How the passive firing pin safety works on modern handguns, this time on gun physics. There are two important parts that you can easily see if you do a basic disassembly of a handgun. First, this is a part of the trigger bar, that little protrusion, and then there's a little nub in there that pushes up into the slide. So I'm going to reset the trigger, show you how this works. When you pull that trigger, it actuates the trigger bar on the right-hand side, which then operates the mechanism which pulls the striker back and then releases it. As the trigger bar is pushed back by the trigger, that protrusion slides backward and pushes up on this little plunger, which is the firing pin safety, moves it out of the way. At the rear of the slide is the striker, that little piece you see there. It's the back end of it. On the front end is the firing pin, and it's limited. It can only go forward so far, and that firing pin can't protrude past the breech face, so the firing pin safety is actuated right now. So I bought a 40 caliber barrel off eBay, and it came with these extra parts, which will be pretty significant in showing you how this works. This spring and that little nubbin right there, those are the firing pin safety, and there it is in the slide. That little spring drops into the base of the safety and pushes down toward the frame of the firearm. In my right hand is the spring-loaded striker with the firing pin at the very end of it. My left is the firing pin safety, and that firing pin safety gets pushed down into that little slot and stops the striker is from pushing that firing pin all the way forward and keeps it behind the breech face. But when you pull the trigger, it pushes that safety up and out of the way so that the firing pin can slide forward past the breech face and hit the primer. So when you pull the trigger, that trigger bar comes back, pushes the passive firing pin safety up and out of the way so that the striker can come all the way forward. So the trigger comes back, firing pin safety gets pushed up, allowing the striker to move all the way forward. All right, one final view. This is the breech face where the back of the cartridge sits. That is the firing pin safety, and that is the back of the striker. Spring loaded. So you try to push forward on that firing pin, on that striker, and it stops before the breech face because of the firing pin safety. But when you push that firing pin safety out of the way, look at that. So when this firearm gets dropped, there's a mechanical system that keeps that firing pin from sliding forward. It's not going to fire no matter what you do with it. Now that doesn't mean you can go be an idiot. And please make sure your firearm is functioning properly, but that's how it works.